just the two of us. We can make it if we try, just the two of us.
Hey y'all, Bill V, Hall of Fame Collector here. Another video, of course. This to me is therapy, so I'm enjoying, you know, taking time out of the stressful situation to just post some of my pickups that I've had over the last few months that have accumulated, and then of course showing off some stuff. I have plenty of new subscribers, so happy to see that. And I love the comments. Guys, just comment. Just say, hey, I watched this video. How's it going? I love seeing that. New commenters, I love seeing that too. I've had a few of those, so just happy. It's been stressful here. I'm in North Jersey. And it's pretty bad here, so just take note, everybody, maybe people that live somewhere else and it's not really that bad, just be smart. Just think about people that we love. We don't want to pass this on. Just take it from there. It's been stressful for me and the fiance. We had a bridal shower this weekend that was supposed to take place. Well, that didn't happen. And now our wedding in July is not looking like it's going to happen. So this whole thing just sucks. And there's, you know, everyone has different opinions and there's fights and arguments. We all just want to be safe. So hopefully you guys like this stuff and maybe I can keep you entertained on a boring day. So check it out. All right, there are some items we just could never get rid of, and this is one of them. I love this item. Just figured I'd share it with you guys, some new subscribers. This is my Triz speaker autograph. It is beautiful, magnificent. I think this one's going to the grave with me. It's August 12th, 1923, signed. I love his penmanship. What a great player. Look him up if you don't know him. 3,500 and something hits from the Dead Ball era. He, Cobb, and Wagner, really, and Lajoie are those four big names. This is so important and such a cool item. It's even featured on PSA DNA's site as an authentic example. I'm so thrilled to have owned this for as many years as I've had it.
Mirror, mirror on the wall, is this not the most perfect
insert
of them all?
Now, if you don't know already what I'm referring to Select Certified Mirrors. The Select Certified product, specifically in 96, you'll see in 95, but the 96 product really changed the game in terms of rarity. From what is written online, this is one of those sets where you had colored parallels, which was relatively a new thing, and just the production run, even though they weren't serially numbered, the production run was so low that these cards are super highly sought after. All right, so let me show you the first mirror here. This one's 95. Listen, this is a card everyone should have. This is the 95 Mirror Gold. It's one in five packs. It's a parallel. There's about 1,853 of these produced. But this is 95. This is the cheapest. You can get them pretty cheap. I think I paid less than 10 bucks for this card. But it basically paved the way for 96, which is the crazy ones. All right, now I take you to 96. 96 Select Certified. These cards redefined the industry in terms of rarity and what they did with print runs and parallels. This is the artist proof. So it's basically the base card, and they have that stamp there, artist proof. And the artist proof was 1 in 18 packs with 144 cards. The chance of pulling the player you want was 1 in 2,592. And the print run on this card was stated at 500. So not an easy card. For that era, 500 is a very, very low number for that time. You have to understand this, guys. But just a beautiful card. Now I'm moving on to some other ones. All right, this one's very nice. It's the easiest one. It's the Certified Red. 1 in 5 packs. 1 in 720 to get the player you want. And print run of approximately 1,800. It's a really nice card. It's not holographic at all. But it just looks cool next to the other ones. Just, you know, color parallels were a new thing back then. So, really nice card. Be on the lookout for these. This is just like the red, but it's blue. This is the Certified Blue. These were 1 in 50 packs to get the player you want. 1 in 7,200 packs. The print run is only 180, which is absurdly low for 96. They look really nice together. That's the Certified Blue. All right, here's the big one in my collection thus far in terms of the mirrors. This is the Mirror Red. This parallel here is beautiful. The shine, the surface is gorgeous. It's like glass. It's 1 in 100 packs. To get the player you want, you got to open 14,400 packs. The print run, guys, 96. Keep that in mind. Print run's 90. Very low. This card's beautiful. And just think, there is a Mirror Blue, which is twice as hard to get and numbered to 45, or print run to 45. And then there's the Mirror Gold, which is this one of the staples in the 90s collections. One in 300 packs on a print run of just 30. Boy, one day, maybe one day.
It's okay, it's okay. You guys speak English? No? Right, okay, I don't know what that means, and I know that you and I kind of got off on the wrong foot last night, but little birdie told me that somebody likes magic.
Magic.
All right, I just had to play that video because of this card. It reminded me of magic. Look at this card. Look at how that switches over. This is 99 Metal Universe Diamond Soul, 1 in 72 packs, 1 in 1,080. This card's gorgeous, don't you think? Now here's something that's also unique. This is 2000 Crown Royale. This is a proof. This thing is so thin and floppy, it's like a negative. It's 1 in 25 packs or 1 in 900 for the player you want. Just a unique card. You kind of have to have a different color background to see there. Just an interesting card from 2000. Here's a boring card, but not that easy to get. It's an Upper Deck Retro from 99. This is a distant replay, but this is the hard-to-find parallel. And this is dot matrix number to 100. So ugly, but rare. Now for something very unique also. How about this? This is like an ornament. There's a little hole on top for a string to hang on your tree. It's 01 Pacific Ornaments. 1 in 18 and a half packs. Weird card. Stick with the same year and set. The Gold Crown Die Cuts. This is your standard one. 1 in 73 packs. 1 in 2,628 to get Maddox. Pretty cool. There's other parallels. Now I go back to 1994, and we have here the Leaf Limited Gold Stars. These were 1 in 7 packs, and what was cool about these nice shiny cards were they were numbered to 10,000, which in 94 was pretty cool to own one of these. So there you go, 94. These ones are straight up pretty. We have the 99 Revolution Thorn in the Side. These are 1 in 25 packs. Or to get the player you want, 1 in 500 packs. I just love the die cut action there, the thorns, the shine. Just a really nice card overall. All right, and to round it out, I got cards that are printed to 500. Here's the 98 Rookies and Stars True Blue Parallel. These were 1 in 8 packs, 1 in 2,712 to get the player. You can see there at the bottom, it is 1 in 500. Pretty cool. All 170 cards of the 98 Donruss set had a silver and gold press proof. Here's the gold press proof of the Maddox, and it is die cut, and again, 1 of 500. And the same exact thing applies to this card, same set, same everything. Gold, press proof version of another base card of Maddox in that set to 500. And because I did not say this enough, the same set, same year, same everything, another base card with the gold press proof. It's the fan club, again, to 500. And rounding out this video is another Leaf Rookies and Stars from 98. True Blue, another base card parallel. This is the True Blue, and it is again to 500. So y'all stay safe now, and say hi.